Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 15.6.1 to the public. This is available to all iOS 15 supported devices from the iPhone 6S, 6S Plus to the iPhone 13, 13 Pro Max, and third generation iPhone SE. And if you're not seeing the update, all you need to do is go to your settings, go down to General, Software Update, check for an update, and you should see it there. If you're still not seeing it, turn off automatic updates, check again, and you should see it. Now, this is available, like I said, everywhere around the world, but if you're a beta tester on iOS 16, you actually won't see this update. So you'll actually need to downgrade using a computer. Also, make sure you don't have iOS 15 beta profiles installed, as that would show you only iOS 15 betas, and you need to uninstall the beta profile in order to see it if you are a previous beta tester. Now, this came in at a fairly small 282.5 megabytes. That's on my iPhone 13 Pro, but was a couple hundred megabytes on all the devices that you'll see in this video. Now, along with this, Apple also released iPadOS 15.6.1, watchOS 8.7.1, along with macOS 12.5.1. All of those are available for everyone all around the world at the same time. Now, let's take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, then we'll go to General, then About. If we tap on the version number, you can see the build number is 19G82. And with a 0.1 update, meaning 15.6 and then 0.1, we're typically going to see bug fixes and then security updates. And if we take a look at the release notes, Apple says this update provides important security updates and is recommended for all users. So as far as what's new, Apple has not specified anything specifically. However, there are some updates to talk about. GarageBand, if you use that app, has some major updates today. So if we go down to GarageBand here in our updates, we'll go down to GarageBand. And within GarageBand, under Sound Library, Apple announced today that they're adding some options for 17 remix sessions and then also Katy Perry remix sessions. You can also see modular rhythms, and so you have all of those with new loops and more with the Sound Library. So that's updated in GarageBand. And then also, there's some recent news about the upcoming Apple event for iPhone 14, 14 Plus, iPhone 14 Pro, and iPhone 14 Pro Max. According to Mark Gurman, Apple is planning to hold this on September 7th. So that's something that came out today. However, Apple has not sent out invites yet. As far as resolved issues in this update, well, I would expect quite a few resolved issues. Now, we haven't had any issues with the green screens on here or pink screen for quite some time. However, I haven't heard from people whether or not that's resolved. When it comes to the storage issue, that continues to be a concern for people. So let's go into the iPhone SE. So we have the second gen SE here, and I didn't notice any issues with it this time around. So let's see if we can turn on dark mode, and I'll go into this in real time for you. So we'll go to iPhone storage, go to storage, and it seems to load like you would expect. Nice and fast. It loaded already on the SE and now on the 13 Pro Max or the 13 Pro that has more storage on it. The system data is taking up 6 gigabytes on the iPhone SE and only 7 gigabytes on the iPhone 13 Pro. I really wouldn't worry about this too much. Typically, it's staying nice and low. iOS 16 betas seem to have an issue with it, but the storage bug overall seems to be fixed with iOS 15. When it comes to the music bug, well, we haven't heard about that in a while, and Apple never said that they fixed anything when it came to using more processing power. However, I know of some people with 15.6 that were having issues with using music and then having it sort of stop playing after 15 seconds. This is something that hopefully is fixed. I haven't experienced, and if that's fixed for you, let me know in the comments below. Now, in this update, there's some security updates as well. So if we go into Safari, we can see those. Now, on Apple's security website, if we scroll down, we can see what they've actually resolved. And they've fixed 2 issues, just 2 in this update, one for kernel, that's sort of the underlying code that runs the OS, and then WebKit, that's the code that runs Safari. And as you can see under impact, that's what the problem was, and then description is the fix. So it says impact, an application may be able to execute arbitrary code with kernel privileges. Apple is aware of a report that this issue may have actively been exploited. A description to fix it was an out-of-bounds write issue was addressed with improved bounds checking. The same sort of vulnerability or concern was happening with WebKit, and again it says processing maliciously crafted web content may lead to arbitrary code execution. Apple is aware of a report that this issue may have been actively exploited. Again, the description is similar. An out-of-bounds write issue was addressed with improved bounds checking. So that has been updated not only in iOS, but iPadOS 15.6.1 and the other watch updates as well. So as far as if you should install iOS 15.6.1, if you're on iOS 15.6, absolutely. This will patch those vulnerabilities. And typically when there's security updates, I always recommend you install it as that fixes those issues and then makes your device more secure. As far as future updates, iOS 15.7, we should see maybe a new update in September. That's what they did last year with iOS 14.8, but we'll have to wait and see. iOS 15.6.1 could be the final version if Apple deems it stable enough and then, of course, secure enough. If not, we'll see a final update in September like they did last year. As far as iOS 16 betas, iOS 16 beta 7, I would expect as soon as next week. Typically, we have weekly updates with those. We had beta 6 this week. I would expect beta 7 early next week with release candidates to follow and then a final release sometime in mid-September. As far as overall battery life, typically most users that are using iOS 15.6 have said that the battery life was pretty good. However, after a few weeks, it can degrade for some, and I'm seeing different results. So with 15.6.1, it will take a little while to know for sure. Battery health on this device is 100%. And then over the last 10 days, you'll see I've been testing this on and off, using it for different videos, but we'll have to test it over the next few days to see what it's like, as it has to do a lot of processing in the background and updates typically affect that. So we should see this improve, but we don't know for sure until we use it for a couple days. As far as the overall performance seems to be pretty good, whether that be on the iPhone SE that we have here, the second gen, or something else. Generally, it seems to be fast, whether that's opening music, going into different apps, we'll go to browse. It's loading off the same Wi-Fi connection. It might have been a little bit stuttery there, but as far as ProMotion on the iPhone 13 Pro, it's been smooth as far as I've been using it over the past hour. Launching things such as the camera seems to be nice and fast, no issues there, and just opening different apps in general seems to work as you would expect. Going into the App Store, it loads without an issue. Again, it's pulling internet data, so that can depend on your internet connection speed, but in general seems to be nice and fast. As far as the overall temperature or getting warm or overheating, it does feel a little bit warm, but that's going to happen as it's processing more and more in the background. So typically that's what you'll see. It gets warm, then it will cool down after it's done processing and indexing information. It should cool down over the next day or so as it completes doing that. That's everything with iOS 15.6.1, and this is a nice little update to get us prepared for iOS 16, which should be out in just a few weeks. Of course, I'm looking forward to that iPhone 14 event and those updates, and let me know what you're looking most forward to in the comments below. Of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.